President Trump and the First Lady have been making waves everywhere they've gone on their tour of nations over the past few days. The first couple, along with a few other members of the Trump clan, have been involved in diplomatic meetings, as well as various religious gatherings, press conferences, and handshaking. The damage that the Obamas did to our country's reputation was pretty bad, but if anybody can fix it, the Trumps would be the ones to take it on. During their trip, the couple has made headlines with not only what they've done, but in some cases what they haven't done. For instance, the First Lady did not wear any kind of head covering when meeting with the Middle Eastern leaders, as many have before her, but the Saudi king showed her great respect anyway. The first couple took a direct flight from Saudi Arabia to Israel, which is not something that is ever done, but an exception was made for them. Melania did, however, show great respect during the first couple's visit with the Pope. While the President and First Lady are not Catholic themselves, they obviously have great respect for the religion and the man who had dedicated his life to helping others on their spiritual journey. Via right-wing news, Donald and Melania Trump are on the third and final leg of the first presidential overseas trip. Trump first went to Saudi Arabia, then to Israel, and is now in Vatican City, meeting with Pope Francis. The Trumps arrived in Rome Tuesday night, and while the details of what happens during the visit are yet to be determined, all eyes were on Melania for her stellar and modest style. Melania met Pope Francis Wednesday morning alongside her husband, as well as Ivanka Trump and Jared Kushner. Both women honored the traditional Vatican dress code, which calls for black, long-sleeved dresses and veils. Melania took it a step further, wearing Italian-designed Dolce & Gabbana as a nod to her time in Italy. It was a surprising move, considering that both Melania and Ivanka decided to forego the traditional headscarves worn by women while in Saudi Arabia. While it is required for Saudi women to wear them, no such requirement is in place for foreign visitors, although it is not unusual for female foreign leaders to cover their heads anyway, as a sign of respect. Still, both Ivanka and Melania dressed modestly while they were in Saudi Arabia, although they didn't skimp on their signature glamorous style. But when Ivanka visited the Western Wall while in Jerusalem, she did choose to cover her head, as is custom for Jewish women. Ivanka converted to Judaism in 2009 for her husband, Jared Kushner. Pope Francis is said to be interested in relaxing dress code guidelines for private audiences with the Pope, which were in place for his predecessor, Pope Benedict XVI, and previous popes. Women were required to wear black, long-sleeved dresses with a lace mantilla, unless they were royalty from a handful of Catholic nations who were eligible for the privilege of the white robe. Princess Charlene of Monaco exercised that privilege, for example, wearing a white crepe jacket and white gloves for her visit with the Pope. But while the rules have been relaxed over recent years, it is common for visiting heads of state to still abide by them, as a way of showing respect. Melania's outfit for her papal audience has received applause, as she managed to not only look reverent and appropriate for the occasion, but stylish and glamorous as well. I'm sure the question on everyone's mind is, why did the First Lady cover her head for the Pope, and not for the Muslims? While I obviously don't have any special information about what's going on in her head, to me there are a few obvious reasons. The first being that when the first family met with the Saudi king, they were outside, and in his home and around and about a country, not in a religious place. That's reason number one. The second would be that Islam is a religion that is notorious for its horrific treatment of women, and hatred for Christians, many of whom the Trumps were representing on their trip. I could get into that further, but I'm sure you know what the Muslims do to women in their own countries. Melania's not wearing a head covering was somewhat of a step forward for women in that country. The last reason is that the Catholic faith is one that close to 25% of Americans consider themselves to be a part of. Even though the Trumps themselves aren't members of the faith, they obviously represent that part of the population while on their trip and gave the religious leader the respect that he deserved. Source: Right Wing News. Share if you think Melania is a great representative for America.
Please do not forget to subscribe and like and comment, because we want to hear your voice, and thank you for watching.